There's three of us. Look closely, you will see. There's three of us. Just three of us. There's him and you and me. And every day we all hang out to find out what we talk about.
And every day's a new surprise
when you're learning with us guys.
We live in an actual nightmare.
Three of us, just three of us, us three.
What you just saw was the intro scene to the television series known as Don't Hug Me, I'm Scared, or DHMIS for short. Don't Hug Me, I'm Scared is an animated comedy horror which is juxtapositioned as a typical children's show. Each episode revolves around a singular topic, much like a children's show, with all of them having an underlying meaning or message behind each episode. What started out as a fascinating web series with its own plot and narrative back in 2011 has since evolved into its own television series that is adored by thousands of old and new fans alike. As someone who grew up with watching this series on YouTube, I absolutely had to see the television series. And let me just tell you this now, a lot of things I have to say about this are good. So without further ado, let's dive into my review of Don't Hug Me, I'm Scared. And let's start off with the presentation. Don't Hug Me, I'm Scared's presentation has aged gracefully as the years have gone by. Disguising its appearance as a generic children's show and using teachers to teach the characters and the audience about different topics, whilst also having ulterior motives or misleading information, is always going to be a genius concept, let's just get that across. Now the television series absolutely aces the foundation that the YouTube series has set before it. It even comes with an entire intro theme song that is different every time you watch it. Speaking of music, the songs in this are absolutely catchy as fuck, and they're very fun to listen to. I'd even go as far as to say that they're better than the original songs from the YouTube series. That fucking vending machine song has been stuck in my head for about 3 weeks now. I can't get it out, please help. The teachers are really fun to watch on screen as well. Each one is great, but my favourite would have to be the coffin. Just the way he's trying to remain calm and nonchalant about Ducky being dead, whilst also dealing with his bullshit, was really fun to watch. Though, being honest here, my least favourite had to be the train car thing. He's just really boring and like he wasn't really engaging, but I guess that was intentional, but who knows. But overall though, the presentation hasn't aged a single bit bad. It's just as good as it was 10 years ago. But alas, let's dive into the juicy content of today's video, and that would be the story elements. Let's get into it. Now, Don't Hug Me, I'm Scared is a series renowned for its innovative messaging and storytelling. The original series revolved around a kids show that slowly abandons creativity and freedom in favor of building around the norms of society's expectations before it is inevitably rebooted by the red guy to favor the character's favorite colors and goes back to its simplistic start. With that in mind, what is the story behind the television series? Well, as of right now, it's up to anyone's interpretation. We don't really have a solid idea yet. For me personally, I believe that these three characters are trapped in a purgatory cycle that was created by the key character Leslie after she lost her son David in a car accident. The yellow guy with D on his overalls is meant to represent her son David, which she even confirms herself with, "You're not my real son!" Anyway, before I go on a theory tangent, let me just call the story of the series there and get into the messages of each episode, as each episode seems to have a message. Episode 1, titled Jobs, is a message about the workplace and its system, how every employee behaves like a cog in a machine, repeating a seemingly endless cycle over and over again until they're old and worthless, all the while blinded to this fact by the money. Episode 2, titled Death, is about coming to terms with the loss of a loved one in different ways while surrounded by people mourning for a person they didn't even know, before eventually trying to mould someone into something similar like the person they lost, as a way to cope with their loss. Episode 3, titled Family, sends a message about the toxicity of a family life. Yellow Guy becomes part of the family as if he was joining a demonic cult that sought to use him for a discount on chicken, I guess. Ducky decides against family life but secretly wouldn't mind taking up a father role in the family. Meanwhile, Red Guy takes a blood test to find his long-lost family, only to realise he doesn't fit in whatsoever, and that his apparent family could care less if he found them or not. Episode 4, titled Friendship, describes the life of a toxic and manipulative friendship, though it could also be a message about anxiety due to the whole worm in your brain segment, as the characters come out and dismiss their fears because, you know, it's just a worm in your brain, being utilised to scare you. Now, episode 5, Transport, was a little trickier to figure out. From what I gathered, I guess the message is that you always end up back home in some way, no matter how far you go, I guess. Like I said, this one was a little trickier for me to figure out, so comment down below what your theory is. I'd love to hear it. And lastly, Electricity, episode 6, is a message about how everything is becoming reliant on electricity for the sake of convenience we never needed, and that it's too much electricity being used. Like I said, a lot of this is up to interpretation, but these are the messages I gathered from each episode. But overall though, the story still holds up as an entertaining experience, and it gets you invested very quickly. It's very well done. But now let's get on to the more important segments of any show, the entertainment factor.
Now, it's time for some lovely remarks by the best friend.
What? I'm not the best friend.
Yes, you are.
I'm your best friend.
Yeah. We're close.
I mean, I know you. I know which one you are.
Look, I'm leaving you all my stuff.
Yeah, but I don't want it. I mean, that's just our stuff. Anyway, that's our plates.
And my diary.
There's nothing in it.
It's new. I just got it.
I could do the lovely remark.
I don't want you. I want my best friend.
I'm not your best
friend. Hey, look. Just speak from the heart.
The Don't Hook Me on Scared television series is surprisingly hilarious. There are so many moments that made me chuckle or outright laugh because it was just so unexpected. While the YouTube series was like comedic in a few instances, the television series has a lot more comedic moments that don't stray too far away from the tone that the show sets. Whether the comedy stems from absurdity, shock, gore, or otherwise, it almost always hits and it's very well written and presented. The episodes as a whole, though, are just very entertaining to watch in general. Whether they're hooking you in with the mystery, the suspense, the music, and so on, one thing's for certain, they really know how to write and have fun engaging plots. Even the worst episodes that struggle with a sloggy pacing are a joy to sit through just because the characters' interactions are so entertaining to see on screen. And it doesn't even end there, the credits sometimes have fun skits as well, so there's even entertainment at the very end of the episode for you to enjoy. But as a whole, the television series is incredibly entertaining and I love it to pieces. It's just that good, and I was a little scared that when they announced that they made it into a television series that it wouldn't fit. It'd feel too much like the YouTube series, just extended out to 20 minutes. But they exceeded my expectations, and I couldn't be happier. With that, let's finalize this video and move on to my conclusion for this amazing and well done series. Don't Hug Me, I'm Scared is an amazingly presented masterpiece in the making. From its storytelling, to its presentation, to its entertainment, everything just works so well and it serves as a very fun time to watch. If you're into gory yet mysteriously engaging plots disguised as the average kids show, I couldn't recommend the show more for you, it's just that good. If you haven't watched the full episodes and you've only seen clips of the montages around YouTube or theory videos, make sure you go and watch the episodes in full, it's well worth your time and I guarantee you won't be disappointed. I'm so looking forward to the next season, if there is a second season, and I hope it's just as good as this one, because let's remember, this is the first season of potentially many to come, and I believe, personally, this is a masterpiece in the making.